Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at task scheduling in Laravel. First of all, we'll be looking at what is task scheduling and how to use it. And in the end of the video, we'll be looking at how to set it up for the real server. I'll show you how to add it in a shared hosting like this. And also if you have a dedicated server, then also I'll show you how to do that. So without any further ado, let's get started. So basically, if you want to do a task at a later point of time, but not now, then you will schedule it at a certain point of time. So that is basically a task scheduling. And in a server, we can do that by using cron-jobs. And in Laravel, we'll handle that cron-job using task scheduling. And Laravel makes it so much easier to use it. So first of all, let's see how to use it. We have to go into this app console kernel. So here I'm currently in this app console kernel file. And you can see here, there is a schedule method over here. And whatever we write inside this schedule method, Laravel will run it automatically. And we have to do certain work to make it run automatically, and we'll see that at the end of this video. So first of all, let's see one thing. Let's say we want to run a task every minute. So we cannot do it for every second, but we can do it from minutes in a cron job. That's the limitation of cron job, not Laravel. So let's say we want to run something every minute, then we can do it in this way. So this is the basic way. I'll just paste it over here, and instead of db table, we'll just do info. We'll just log it to our laravel.log file. So here I'll say called every minute, and instead of daily, we'll say every minute. So here guys, it can be anything, not only the logging. So it can be any complicated logic, and this code will run every minute. But to test it locally, let's see how we can do this. So let me go to the top here, and here run the scheduler locally. Then we can just run this PHP artisan schedule work. So let me run this over here. So the schedule worker has started, and you can see here it has already called this method, whatever we have run here. And if I go in the laravel.log, you can see here call every minute, and it called it in 1855, and you can see here it's 6:55 p.m. which is 1855. Now I'll come back just before 1 minute completes. So here guys, you can see now this one called every minute is now again called, because it is already present here and we have written here every minute. Now let's say we want to call it every 2 hours. So we can say every 2 hours like this. And there are a bunch of helper methods that we'll see in the documentation. So this is the basic thing that we can do using Laravel scheduler or task scheduler. So we can not only schedule the closure, but we can also schedule PHP artisan commands, some scripts or a job. And you can see it in the documentation over here like this. I'll show you at the top. So here, scheduling an artisan command like this. So you can just schedule it like this. So here we have called here schedule called, but here we'll say schedule a command. So I'll quickly show you that one as well. So I'll say here, so let me just stop this, and now let me create a command, hello world command. And it's inside this app console commands hello world command. And let me say it hello world. Whatever we write here, we can call via PHP artisan. And now instead of logging here, we'll just log it over here. And we'll say here, hello world. And now here we'll say command hello world like this. Now it will call this hello world command every minute. For that, we need to just run this PHP artisan schedule work. And let me remove this laravel.log file. Now 1 minute is about to be completed. So let's see, whenever we reach 59 over here, then it will log this or not. So you can see here guys, it has logged the hello world. Now, whenever it reaches the 7 p.m., then it will again log. Similarly, you can log this shell commands like this. After the schedule, you can call this exec, and then you can just give the path of the script that you want to run and give the timing. Similarly, you can also schedule a queued job. So you can see here, instead of writing this command over here, we can just write a job, and we can just pass job object over here, and then it will just run that job. Now let's see what are the options that we have. So let's go to this schedule frequency options, and here we have every minute, every 2 minutes, every 3 minutes, and there are lots of options. And you can also pass this raw cron job command. So you can go ahead in the documentation and look everything that you can use. And I'll be leaving this link just below that like button. And also one thing I want to show you guys, let's say you want to run some code on a weekly basis, but it must be on Monday exactly at 13. Then you can just chain the commands like this. So it will run every Monday at 1 p.m. Similarly, you can also set the time zone over here. Let's say your application is set to a certain specific time zone, but you want to schedule a command on a different time zone, then you can also set that. And this command, what it does is it will run hourly on the weekdays between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. So between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. it will run hourly, and on the other hours it will not run. So you can see that it is so much powerful. So let me go to the top again, and there are few very important things that you need to know whenever you are using task scheduling. So let me show you those now. One of them is preventing task overlaps. So let's go here. So what it says is, by default, scheduled tasks will run even if the previous instance of the task is still running. To prevent this, you may use without overlapping. So let me show you this. So here we have run this hello world artisan command every minute. Now let me go to that command over here. Let me delay this by more than 1 minute. So here I'll say sleep, let's say 65 seconds. And here I'll write another info over here and hello world before and hello world after, like this. Now let me run the scheduler. So if you look here in the time, it is 7:05, and if you look here in the Laravel log, there is nothing over here. So here we are about to reach the 7:06. Now you can see here we have reached 7:06, and there is hello world before that is logged. But if you look here, we have delayed more than 1 minute, and after 1 minute, this hello world after will get logged. But if you see here in the kernel, we are running this command every minute. So before this hello world after gets logged, this command will get again executed, and the scheduler will not wait for that command to get completed. So if you see here guys, it's already 7:07, and if we go here in the Laravel log, then you can see here we are again getting hello world before. We are getting this before hello world after, which proves that the scheduler command doesn't wait for previous commands to be completed. No matter what, it will run the previous one. But let's say we don't want this behavior, then what we can do is we can just say here without overlapping. So here if you go here in the kernel and let's say without overlapping like this, and let me come here and remove this one for now. And if you see the time here, it's 7:10 already. So now you can see here it has been logged hello world before. But now what will happen is it will wait for this whole command to be completed, and then only it will run the next command. Now what happens is, even after 1 minute has gone, then it will not run this command. It will wait for this command to get completed, and only after that it will run this hello world. So let me go here, and we are about to hit 7:11, and you will see that it will not log that hello world before. And you can see here guys, it logged the hello world after, and it did not log this hello world before again. It just waited for everything to get completed. Now at 19:12, it will again run this command. And you can see here guys, it's 19:12, and it ran this hello world before. Now let's move to another important thing that you need to know. Here in the documentation, it's running tasks on one server. If the scheduler is running on multiple servers, or let's say you have implemented load balancing in your server, and if you have scheduled this command at 17:00, let's say every day, then it will run on every server. And let's say you have 3 servers, then it will run 3 times. So to prevent that from happening, you can just add this on one server, and then it will run on only one server. And the third most important thing that you need to know is about background tasks. So let me just show you this. So let's say you have 3 tasks that are scheduled at the same time. But what happens is, one task will get completed, then only the second task will be called. But if you want all those tasks to run at the same time, then you can add this run in background. So let me show you that also. So here in the kernel file, so let me just remove this one from here and let me run it 3 times, okay? And now here in the command, I'll just remove this and I'll just add here 2 seconds. And you can see here, I am running 3 commands. So this can be different actions that you want to perform. So I am running here 3 commands every minute. So all of them will run at the same time. So currently I am here at 7:15. But when I reach 7:16, then first this command will get run and it will wait for 2 seconds, print this one. And after that, it will again run this command and wait for 2 seconds and run this info. And again, it will run this hello world and wait for 2 seconds one more time. So it is the default behavior. So here guys, if you see here, I have already reached 7:16. So now if I come here in the Laravel log, now you can see here guys, the timestamp over here, okay? So you closely look at this timestamp. So it has run on 2, 4 and 6, which means that it ran this and it waited for 2 seconds and then ran this and again waited for 2 seconds and then ran this. But let's say you want to run all of them at 16:02 at the same time. Then you can just add this run in background. So let me go here in the kernel and here, I'll say here run in background like this. So I'll come here and clear this out. And if I show you guys here, I'm here in 7:17. Now, whenever I reach 7:18, then all those logs will get logged without any delay. So you can see here all of them logged at the same time. So if you want this behavior, just to add this run in background, and then all the tasks that are scheduled at the same time will run at that specific time. They will not get delayed. So these are the main things that you need to know about this task scheduling. And also one more thing that you need to know here is during the maintenance mode, all the scheduler will not get executed. But if you want any schedule that needs to be executed whenever we are in the maintenance mode, then you can add this even in maintenance mode method over here, and then it will run on the maintenance mode as well. Now let's see how we can add this schedule in our shared hosting. So here in the documentation, you can see here running the scheduler. And if you see here, we have to just add this command in a cron job and then everything will automatically work. So basically what you need to do is you just need to give the path of the project over here and everything will automatically work. So let me copy this one and now let me go to the shared hosting over here. Now I'll go to the file manager over here. And you have to just give the path of the folder wherever your Laravel project is located. So currently this project is located inside this public_html folder and the path will be this path /public_html. So I'll go here in the cPanel and I'll search for cron-job here and I'll go here. And some of the shared hosting will have these options and some will not have these options. So what you need to do is just add this once per minute. So here everything will have asterisks. So if you don't have these options, then just write 5 asterisks and then just write the command. So before I just copied all these commands, I don't need to copy all these commands because all these 5 asterisks will be automatically added to me by these options. Okay. So here I'll just copy from here and I'll paste it over here. And here I'll write the path of my project. So here I'll say like this. And this should match where you have added your Laravel project. So this folder, okay? So from here, starting from here to here. And whenever I do this and I'll add a new cron job, you can see here it has added the cron job. And now it will run every minute. And it will check in this kernel file in our Laravel application and it will see whatever there is inside this schedule method and it will run those at the specified time that you have given here. Okay, now we have seen how to add this scheduler command in the shared hosting. And now I'll show you how you can add it to the virtual server or a dedicated server. So it is the same way how it will work in our local Linux machine. So I am currently in the Ubuntu 18.04 and it will work for any version of Ubuntu servers. So just SSH into your server and run these commands. So I'll show you here. So let me just exit this. You need to log into your server and you need to have the sudo privileges. Then what you can do is sudo cron-tab dash e. Just run this command here like this and provide the password. And you will see all these things. So these are all the comments. Don't worry about this. If you want to delete these, then you can delete them. I'll just go to the bottom of the file and I'll add whatever I have copied. So I have pasted it over here. And now instead of this path to your project, I'll just add the path to my project. And if I go here and add a new terminal and I just do pwd, then it will give me the path of the current directory. So I am currently in the root of my project and it is giving me this path. So I'll just copy this and I'll go here and I'll just delete this and I'll paste it over here and I'll save it now. So I have saved it. Now I don't need to run that PHP artisan schedule work anymore. Okay. So here I am running these three commands in the background and I'll just come here and delete this. And now guys, we are currently at 725 and also 54 and I am not running any of this command, okay? I am not running this command. Now you can see here guys, it has logged this information automatically. We don't have to run now this PHP artisan schedule work anymore. It is running in the background and it will run every minute. And likewise, I have said before, that command will look into our this kernel file and it will just look inside this and it will run whatever is inside this schedule method. So that's it for this video guys, and if you have any confusion related to this, then just let me know in the comment section below and I'll try to solve that as well. So that's it for this video guys. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.